guys, and welcome back to my channel. So for this video, I made a DIY Dollar Tree towel rack, and of course it's glam bowed, or it has mirrors, and it's just really, really pretty. So this would actually, I think, go really good with that bathroom shelf from a couple of weeks ago, maybe about a month ago. But anyway, I love it.
For this project, I'll be using 4 of the storage containers and 10 of the small square mirrors from Dollar Tree. And I actually did this very same thing when I made the vanity light a while back. I laid 2 of the containers face down next to each other so that I make 1 long piece. Then I line 5 mirrors side by side across the back of the containers. Before I glue the mirrors on the containers, I remove the foam pieces that's on the back of the mirrors and the sticker. I used Gorilla Hot Glue. Now you can use E6000 if that's what you want to use. As I mentioned, I've done this a while back and I used the Gorilla Hot Glue and the mirrors are still attached. So when you get to the seam, where the seam of the 2 trays come together, you want to make sure to get plenty of glue on both sides of the middle mirror. After you've applied your 5th mirror, just flip the unit over and add hot glue where that seam of the containers nearly touch. And this will give it a little bit more stability and make it more of one piece. Repeat these steps so that you have another set of mirrors just like this. I like to check the durability of everything before I move on. And like I said, I totally have a lot of trust and confidence in this because of the vanity light I made. I went around the sides of this container with diamond wrap. As it turns out, the 5 rows of diamonds and the 3 rows of diamond wrap from Dollar Tree fit perfect. I picked up 6 of these at signs at Dollar Tree. Now, mine doesn't all match. I really wanted these to all have a mirrored finish. And you obviously won't have to do this step if you can find matching pieces. So what I ended up doing was painting mine all silver, and then I went over them with Mod Podge and glitter, and I let that dry. I reapplied the Mod Podge so that the glitter doesn't shed. I placed the 2 sets of mirrors next to each other so that the mirror seams are lined up. Then I started lining my at signs on top of every other mirror. And then I glued the at signs on mostly with E6000 glue, but I did use a little bit of hot glue. And y'all, I felt this grab right away. The mirror, the illusion of the mirror, I didn't get my first at on when I glued it on. I didn't get it on dead center. And I thought I'd be able to kind of like shift it over a little bit, but I couldn't because it grabbed and it stuck to the mirror so good. So be sure you have this right where you want it. I wish I would have thought about this, but I thought about it afterwards. You could use masking tape to mark your spots for your at signs. So what I have is an at sign on the top mirrors and then the 3rd mirrors and the bottom mirrors, making it 3 at signs on each unit, which is 6 at signs total. Now I'm done for the night, so I take a piece of foam board and I set it on top of the at signs, and I add some shampoo and conditioner, just some bottles I have laying around, for some weight so the epoxy has time to sit up and cure and completely dry before I hang it on the wall. So the next day, I used 2 of these claws from Dollar Tree. I like these because the rod is metal. Dollar Tree just had 2 of them, so I used these 2 and then this little cat toy. The cat toy is plastic, but you don't have to cut it to fit, unlike the claws. So I just took the little claws apart and I laid them next to the cat toy. And with a hacksaw, I cut the claws so that they would all be the same length as the cat toy. And then I just spray painted them all silver. Now I'm ready to hang everything on the wall. And I'll be hanging this up with 2 of the 3-pound command hooks. And I'd actually gotten those at Dollar General. I used my hot knife and I made a hole for my hooks in the top part of the container. After I placed my hooks on the wall, I hung each unit up and then I slid the little rods through the at sign. Now I'm ready to hang up my towels on the rack, and this project is finished.
Because I can pick these up by the A's or the ads or whatever. Yeah, they're on there. For now, and I love you guys so much, and I'll see you very soon in another DIY Dollar Tree project. Y'all have a very wonderful and blessed weekend. Bye.
This is a quote from Christy in the Carolinas, and her says, "You can say what you mean without being me. I love that. Thank you for sharing that with us, Christy. If you know of a quote and you want to share it with us, just leave it in the comments below next to the word quote. That way I can save it for a future video.